In electronics, there are many important formulas, but I don't think I could think of any more that are more important than Ohm's Law. Today, let's dive into why Ohm's Law is so important in the world of electronics and how we can use it ourselves. Ohm's Law describes the relationship between three properties: voltage, current, and resistance. So if you're brand new to electronics, you may not know what these are. So let's go ahead and discuss them. To make it a little bit easier to understand, we're going to compare it to something that we can see in real life. Imagine we have a hillside with a stream flowing down it. We know there's going to be a source of water that feeds into the stream at the top, and the end of the stream is going to be flowing into a lake. The first property we're going to look at is voltage. We can model voltage as the height difference between the top of the stream and the lake. The larger the height distance, the higher potential we have. Likewise, the lower the height distance we have, the less potential we have. Let's now look at current. Current in electronics is essentially the same exact thing as current in a stream, meaning the flowing water. The faster the water is flowing down the stream, the higher the current is. Finally, let's look at resistance. If we had a perfectly smooth stream, we could imagine that the water be flowing down it very, very quickly. However, streams normally have things such as rocks and boulders that slow down this flow of water. This is exactly what resistance is. The most beautiful thing about Ohm's Law is that it defines the balance between voltage, current, and resistance. For example, if we have a fixed resistance and increase the voltage, the current will have to rise. We can also change this formula around to solve for any unknown given any of the other two values. Let's go ahead and dive into examples on paper and practice using this formula, and then build the circuit in real life to verify that our calculations worked. Let's say we have a simple circuit that has a power supply providing 3 volts, and we also know that the resistor's value is 330 ohms. Since we want to know what the current is, we will use the formula current equals voltage divided by resistance. We then simply need to fill in the values and plug them into the calculator to get our final result of 9 milliamps. Let's build the circuit now by plugging one side of the power supply into the top of the resistor and the ground to the other side of the resistor through our multimeter. We can then see that we get the same value as we calculated. The device you're watching this video on now has hundreds of resistors in it, so just imagine how many times this formula was used in the design process. And it is amazing how a simple formula forms the backbone of electronics engineering. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos that explore the fundamentals of creative and interactive technologies. And I'll see you next time.